Let's go into one of the collection rooms in ichthyology. So this is one of many rooms that we have like this, like full of jars of dead fish. And we have over 2 million dead fish specimens here. And there are about 27,000 species of fish on the planet. And what we have here is we're trying to represent each of those species. Now, one of the great insights of Darwin, of course, was that not every individual is the same. You know, species vary, populations vary. So what we try to do with these collections, for each species that we're representing, we're kind of like putting an envelope around them. So we have males and females, we have juveniles. We try and get populations or samples of populations from throughout the range of each species. So we kind of really encapsulate that variation that makes the species what it is. As you start getting into the evolution of fishes, you find a trend, and you find a trend towards this kind of suction feeding anatomy, which is really pretty cool. You have the mouth jaws, so these are your jaws. Here's the lower jaw and the upper jaw, and you can see they have teeth all over them. Now this fish, with it closes its mouth, It has all of its gill apparatus in here, which you can see. It can drop this down, create a negative pressure, suddenly open its mouth, the water comes streaming in, bringing in prey with it. So bits of prey are going to go in there. These coelacanths are thought to be one of the lineages that gave rise to the tetrapod, so that's the four-limbed animal. This should just be a simple fin, which at the end you can see there is a fin, but that fin is borne on this big fleshy appendage here. So I'm actually shaking hands with it. This is the equivalent of my arm. One of the things that we're doing here very actively is going through these collections, making new collections and discovering new species. And in ichthyology, that's actually quite easy to do because there's so much we don't know about the fishes out there on the planet.